In this problem, the length of the wire is given as 1 meter and the resistance R is equal to 26 ohm at 20 degrees centigrade. This information is given. In addition to that, the diameter is given as 0.3 millimeter, that is 0.3 into 10 to the power of minus 3 meter. Immediately we should convert that into SI units. What will be the resistivity of the? So resistivity is asked. And for that, in the extension, after finding the resistivity, you have to name that by seeing the table. Even in examination also, the table will be given, then only you can identify. No need to remember the resistivity of any substance. Okay, so this is, again, we know that R is directly proportional to L, inversely proportional to area of cross section. Therefore, R is directly proportional to L by A. R, you can write R is equal to rho L by A. So from this formula, rho is equal to R A by L. So you have to simply substitute. 26 ohm is given. Area, diameter is given. Area can be written as, cross sectional area can be written as pi d square by 4. How? Area is equal to pi r square. So r is equal to half of the diameter. So you can write pi d square by 4 divided by this length 1 meter. So 26 into, in place of pi, you can put either 22 by 7 or 3.14, and then 0.3 into 10 to the power of minus 3 whole square by 4 into 1. If you simplify this thing, you will get 1.84 into 10 to the power of minus 6 ohm. So if you observe this value, it is of resistivity of manganese. In this question, a wire of given material length L and area as A, and its resistance is 4 ohm. Now it is asked, suppose if length becomes L by 2 and area becomes 2A, what happens to its resistance? And it is also given that the material is same. So immediately you must understand is same because the material is same. The formula for resistivity, R times A by L. Now, as resistivity is same, we can write R1 A1 by L1 is equal to R2 A2 by L2. Now, we will substitute R1 4 A1 A L1 L. These are the details of this. Is equal to R2, that we have to calculate, into area 2A by length L by 2. this 2 will go to the numerator. So 2 into 2, 4 Ra by R2 A by L. Our aim is to calculate R2. So this 4, this 4, this A, this A, this L can be cancelled. So left out is 1 ohm. The next question is, on what factors does the resistance of a conductor depend? So resistance depends on length of the conductor, area of cross section of the conductor, and of course temperature. If length is increased, the resistance is increased. If the area is increased, the resistance is decreased. By combining these two, we have written R is directly proportional to L by A. R is equal to rho L by A. If you increase the temperature, the resistance is also increased because the collisions between two electrons or electrons and the atoms will be increased. So if the temperature is increased, the resistance is also increased. In the next question it is asked, will the current flow more easily through a thick wire or thin wire? So thick wire is having larger area of cross section, thin wire is having lesser area of cross section. So we have studied that electrons can pass through larger area of cross section easily. Therefore, in thick wire, the current flow is more. What is the reason? The resistance is inversely proportional to area of cross section. That is, here the electrons will have lesser resistance, here the electrons will have larger resistance. In this question, resistance in two different cases is same. R1 is equal to R2, but the potential difference V1 is reduced to half. So V2 is half of V1. So I can write V1 as 2V2 from this relation. It's given data. Now he is asking about I1 and I2. So as resistance is same, which is V by I, so we can write V1 by I1 is equal to V2 by I2. Now let us substitute the values here. So V1 is equal to, or V1 by I1 is equal to V2. V2 how much? V1 by 2. So I can cancel out this and I can write I1 is equal to 2I2. Therefore, I2 is equal to half of I1. That is, if potential difference is reduced to half, the current will also be reduced to half. without doing anything, simply Ohm's law, V is directly proportional to I. So if V becomes V by 2, then I must be I by 2. Directly also we can write. We can give the answer by doing like this, or otherwise from Ohm's law we can say if V is reduced to half, I is also reduced to half, because the resistance is unchanged. There is no change in temperature or area of cross section or length of the wire. The answer, why do we prefer the resistance of electric resistance coils? Why do we prefer the resistance coils of electric toaster and electric iron are made up of an alloy rather than a pure metal? The answer is, alloy do not oxidize readily. Alloy do not oxidize readily. That is, it does not catch the fire or does not burn. At higher temperatures, whereas metals will burn. So this is the reason why we use the alloys as resistors or resistance coils in toasters and electrical iron. In this question, by seeing the table of resistivity, you have to identify which of the two is a better conductor. So here the resistivity is given as for iron, the resistivity of iron is given as 10 into 10 to the power minus 6 ohm meter, and for mercury it is 94 into 10 to the power minus 6 ohm meter. So this resistivity is more, this resistivity is less. So rho of iron is less than rho of mercury. Iron is the better conductor. Now in the table, as silver is having the least resistivity, therefore the best conductor is silver. Silver is the best conductor. It was asked in 2 bits. First, we have to compare iron and mercury. Second, we have to name the best conductor. This is the given circuit diagram. Here, there are 3 parts of the question. 1. Calculate the total resistance of the circuit. What is the total resistance? Because this 4 ohm resistance is in connection with the series. The 4 ohm resistor is connected in series with the bulb. Therefore, in series, we know that the net resistance is always R1 plus R2, that is 4 plus 20, which gives 24 ohm. The second bit was asked, the current through the circuit. So, I is asked, net current is always equal to net potential difference by net resistance. Therefore, 6 by 24, which gives 1 by 4, or if it simplified, 0.25 ampere. Now, another question is asked, the potential difference across the electric lamp. So, potential across lamp must be equal to current times resistance of the lamp. As these two are connected in series, the current remains same. So if 0.25 current is passing through 4 ohms, there is no other go, therefore it has to pass through the lamp also. So I can take the current as 0.25 and the resistance is given as 20 ohm. Therefore, you can calculate the potential difference across the lamp is, this you can make it as 25 by 100, so 5 volt. Now, suppose if it is asked, what is the potential difference across this one? So, straight away, as it is totally 6 volt, so it is already 5 volt across this one. So, remaining 1 volt must be here. Otherwise, you can calculate like this. The current or V across the 4 ohm resistance is equal to what? Current I into its resistance. That is 0.25 into 4, which gives us 1 volt. So either by applying the formula you can do, or otherwise we know that net voltage is 6 volt. 5 volt drop is taken across this lamp. Therefore, remaining 1 volt should be across the resistance.